Let's continue with the presentation on word formation. In part one, we had studied synonyms, antonyms, and words often confused. I'm Dr. Manveen Brar from GWPC Sanganer. I teach communication skills. And in the first part, we have looked at word formation, synonyms and antonyms, and words which are liable to be confused. Now, we will continue with word formation. First of all, let's have a look at misspelled words. Commonly misspelled English words are words that are often unintentionally misspelled in general writing. A selected list of common words is presented here under documented list of common misspellings. And we just need to go through them again and again till the meaning, till the spelling is, the lexicon is completely fixed in our minds. Achieve, acquire, advise, address, barren, believe. In this list, as you have seen, sometimes we make a mistake of I and E. We change their order. We bring in the E first, followed by the I. And in words with double words, like barren is spelled with a double R. Sometimes we make a mistake of spelling it with one R. Same is the case with address, barren. And then how I and E are placed. We just need to look at them very carefully to avoid making this mistake. Boundary, buffalo, carriage, chimney, cholera, and committee, as you can see, is one of those rare words which has three double letters like double M, double T, and double E. This is to be seen in most of the question papers, so look at it very carefully. Daughter, departure, devour, discourage, engine, explain. Embarrass again has two double letters, double R and double S. So just study them carefully so that you don't make a mistake in future. And after going through that list, here is a small test for you. Please try it out yourself and self-check or get back to me. Email it to me and I will correct it. Prefixes and suffixes. A prefix is a letter or group of letters that is added at the beginning of a word to form a new word and change its meanings. If you split the word prefix into two, pre, it means before, prior, and fix means to fix, to attach. So prefix is a letter or a group of letters that is added at the beginning of a word. And most of the prefixes of the English language have come either from the Latin language or the Greek language. All of you have heard somewhere or the other that anti, A-N-T-I, anti means against. It's a Greek word, anti. So whenever we add the word anti, it means opposite, wherever we add it. When anti, meaning against, is added to social, it becomes anti-social. Anti is the prefix here. Here is a list of some prefixes. This is a list which help us in forming a negative. Connect, disconnect, form, deform, pathy, apathy, logical, illogical, illiterate, impossible, irresponsible, misunderstood, non-violence. So this is a prefix of negation. Then of time. Chairman, X. X always means previous. Fore means advance. Forecast, foresee. Pre means before. Preschool, pre-primary. Post means afterwards. Re means again. Vice means next to. And here is a list of prefixes which show support coexist, co-worker, then degree and size, normal, abnormal, extracurricular, mini bus, mini skirt. To defeat is to outwit, to outshine. Over means too much, overconfident, overflow. Ultra again means beyond, ultraviolet, ultramodern. Equi always means equivalent, equal. Then we have prefixes used for making verbs: endanger, enable, empower, belittle. Then we have prefixes showing numbers. Bi means two, biannual, bicycle. Tri means three, mono means one, uni means one, multi means many, poly means five. So these are the words which are used as prefixes. Now we come to suffixes. A suffix is a letter or a group of words that is added at the end of the word to form a new word and change its meaning. For example, crecy added to demo becomes democracy. Ness, N-E-S-S, ness added to happy makes it happiness, which is a new word and with a different meaning. Here is a list of suffixes: A-C-Y-A-C, privacy, accuracy, breakage, marriage, denial, dismissal, A-N, American, African, A-N-C-E, assistance, insurance, and then at the end of the page you can see E-S-S, tiger. The feminine gender is created by adding E-S-S, tigress, actor, actress. Then brotherhood, livelihood. Then moving down, S-I-O-N at the end of the page, confusion, commission, member, membership, friend, friendship, happy, happiness, sweet, sweetness. Then you have suffixes that form adjectives: useful, careful, readable, lovable, world, worldly, friend, friendly, child, childlike, man, manlike. Then you have suffixes that form verbs: I-Z-E, criticize, civilize, simplify, beautify, quicken, lengthen, bravely, easily, southwards, upwards, homewards. Now you have got a fairly good idea of how the prefix and the suffix is added. When you are tested on this in the exams, this is the way you get the question. You have these exercises here. Please have a look at that. This is the question. Fill in the blanks by adding a suitable prefix or suffix to the words given in brackets so as to make the sentence meaningful. The machinery has dash its utility. It is time we dash it. The answer is, the machinery has outlived its utility. It's time we replace it. His performance in studies is praise dash. We will add a suffix, worthy. His performance in studies is praiseworthy. The minister sent his dash to the chief minister. Resign, resignation to the chief minister. Dash your college building with colored paper flags. Beautify your college building with colored paper flags. In his school days, he was a dash boy. He was a quarrelsome boy. The government has imprisoned some dash elements. The government has imprisoned some antisocial elements. It was said that the saints could dash the events. It was said that the saints could foretell the coming events. I was just training you to attempt this question. Please complete all the fill in the blanks yourself. And then you have the second exercise where you have to add a suitable prefix, and then exercise 3 where you add a suffix, prefix and then a suffix. Kindly attempt, try out all these yourself, and if you have any questions, please get back to me on my email chandigarh233@gmail.com. Thank you very much.